brave fencer, Musashi.
Alright, welcome back to the final episode of Brave Fence Musashi. And we're going to pick up right where we left off after the fight with Topo. And we'll just load up my save file. I haven't done anything since the last recording, so... yeah, we're just going to do this cold, I suppose, since it's been a while since I've done the final boss fights of the game. But we're pretty much going to be...
Hey!
But it's been a while since I've done the last boss fights of the game, and I have absolutely no health and bincho points right now, so... oh boy. I don't want to use a healing item or anything. But as Topo had mentioned at the end of the last episode, once we finished fighting her and all that, the Crest Guardian is here in Soda Fountain, and, well, guess what we're going to be fighting? Well, no, not Carol Capricola, even though we see him in the background there, or did. But yes, we're going to be fighting the Crest Guardian, which is this big thing here.
Huh? Why am I floating? What the... the Sky Scroll activated itself!
Yep, it's just a big freaking tower. And guess what? I'm going to break the mold here because I don't really think the song is that great. So anyways, holding X down will cause you to float up. And just letting go of it will cause Musashi to fall. And as you can see, you can't really touch these little pillars. And you kind of got to navigate between them. Until you find the core, which... there we go. All you really gotta do is get up to the core and press triangle, smash it with Lumina, and there you go. Now, I know I've got, like, low health right now, but that's alright with me. I still got that S revive. At least I think I do. I better check to make sure I got that in case... yep. I got that S revive, and I'm gonna let that take effect before any other... before I use any other healing items, because I can use those in the final battle. But this fight is pretty much just fly around, locate the core, and smash it. And I think after a number of hits, he'll, well, like he's doing right now, he changes his attack scheme. And Musashi actually moves faster if he's in the same grain, I suppose I could say, as the tower rotating. You'll see here, if I try to go against the tower rotation here, he moves very, very slowly in comparison to some of these other things. But if I go like this here, if I go on this level, he moves a lot faster to the right. And, well, there are a few tricks to find where the core is. Just kind of either go up and down, look up and you can go up and down. Kind of go back and forth as well. Because it can appear in pretty much any of these red eyes. And, oh, this phase, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, this is the laser beam phase. Oh, there's the core right there. But when you see the laser beams here, there'll be these white things in the back there. The red eyes will turn white. And... they'll shoot a laser beam. Very easy to avoid, actually, if you just fly to a different level and you should be able to avoid a beam. Oop, crap. Oh, there I go. I gotta use the S revive. So it just kind of appeared right on me, and that's how I took a hit. So sometimes it's just hard to avoid, and we're back to the first phase again. Now, as you get more hits in, you can see he's almost dead. He'll get faster and faster and faster. And the core will start changing locations on a much faster frequency. And oh crap. This phase is kind of a jerk here. You see those eyeballs and see how they make that red sonar attack of things. Well, if you get hit by that red sonar thing, you not only take damage, but your controls will be reversed. So it'll wear off after a little while, but other than that, you know, it's just it'll wear off and you just kind of got to avoid attacks, but left will be right, right will be left. Up and down don't really have any real function in this battle, really, aside from, you know, facing the tower to hit it with Lumina. And there we go. Okay, so I didn't really explain how to avoid this particular attack, but the eyes will start looking at you and just keep going around until you find a red eye and use that as a safe spot. And where's the core? It looks like he's only got one hit left and he's going back and forth between different phases. Now there might be a way to manipulate where to get the red eyes or the shed eyes in that phase, but for most part I just go look for one and go to it as fast as I possibly can. There's the core! Probably gonna have to go back around because it's moving too fast for me to hit. Yeah, why did I miss that? Anyways, after you get the last hit, Musashi falls to the ground and kaboom, the Tower of Doom, or Death. I forget which it was, but it's basically the same idea. It'll collapse and we get the Sky Crest. So now Lumina will be complete and we'll have all 500 Bincho points that will make it a max stat. Tower of Death. Okay, so now we've got all the scrolls, all the crests, and
the Sky Crest! This is it! Wonder what kind of power I'll get!
And as you might expect, we're going to get a lot of cutscenes here, so I get to be very quiet, and you get to enjoy most of the ending. Get up there. And, well, revelations coming up!
That is as far as you go! Unless you do not care what happens to this girl!
Musashi! Like, hurry up and save me! This guy stinks!
Hey! So you're Flatsky!
That's correct! Capricola, take the Lumina from the midget! What are you waiting for? Get my Lumina! Schnell! Hurry!
It must be easy to give orders and complain about everything. What a life you have. Do you know how many lives you destroyed? Ha! As though you'd regret anything. Why'd I even ask? You can't order me around anymore. I've been waiting for this moment ever since. Ever since you killed my parents!
What are you saying, Capri? I do not remember killing your parents.
Remember this?
John!
That hat! You can't be!
Good for you. You remembered. That's natural. Even you couldn't forget Thirst Quencher's prince. I've come for revenge.
Oh, Thirst Quencher's prince. I thought you died with your parents. But Capricola, that was an accident. I did not mean to.
An accident? Don't make me laugh. I saw everything. You!
John, watch out!
Yee-haw! Bullseye! Hey, Pops, you all right?
That's a good boy. Well done. Now I should get the Lumina from that Musashi.
Musashi! Please help me!
Musashi, don't give it to him!
John, I'm sorry, but I don't know what's going on anymore. Don't worry, though. I won't let Flatsky have his way!
Now that the Lumina is mine, I can rule the world! Ha! Go away, you tomboy! No need for you anymore!
Princess! You're gonna get it, pal! Princess, you all right?
Thanks, Musashi. I'm okay. But like, if we don't do something, Flatsky's gonna take over this world!
Maybe.
Now I will be in the history books. How exciting. Give me eternal power, legendary sword, Lumina! Let us see. First, go over there and get rid of that garbage. Better say your prayers.
I am free. Now no one can stop my plans for destruction.
Why did that monster come out of Lumina?
As I expected.
Like, what's going on?
The Wizard of Darkness wasn't sealed by Lumina, but was sealed within Lumina.
You mean that I've been doing all this to release the Wizard of Darkness?
No wonder Brave Fencer Musashi had Crest Guardians protect the scrolls.
Watch out! It knows we're here!
Musashi, get out of here!
What about you, John?
Don't worry about me. Oh yeah, take care of Leto for me.
Musashi, hurry up!
It's all my fault!
Like, what are you saying? For crying out loud, cream the cream! You can do it, Musashi! Uh-oh. Anyways, I think, like, we should get out of here! Come on, let's go!
Hey, wait for me! Huh? Lumina came back? What's going on?
Sorry to interrupt the movie, but, yeah. Where to begin with all this? Well, let's begin with Dark Lumina himself. Well, we've got three fights ahead of us. This fight, if you could call it that, is nothing more than just a bunch of jumping and platforming to the left. There are three sections to this fight. The first is just a bunch of just get from point A to point B, and that's Dark Lumina 1. There are two more Dark Luminas that we're going to have to fight, and I'll explain those as we get to them. But, yeah. Story-wise, I don't really think I need to explain a whole lot other than, you know, Ruchik apparently never died when we shoved him off the cliff way back when we got the Earth Scroll. And that voice we heard, that telepathic voice we heard when we finally absorbed our first scroll, the Earth Scroll, was actually Dark Lumina. The voices actually match. Colonel Caprol this whole time has been John, the prince whose kingdom had been usurped by the usurper, Fyodor Flatsky. So, I think that's pretty obvious if you just kind of follow along with what's going on, but it does get a little bit confusing there and all that, but... Alright, so I think I'm just going to head to the left, because that's the way I'm going to go. Quite abnormal for games to have me not going to the right. This time we're going to the left. And if you fall off, well, I screwed up there. I should have been double jumping.
What a laugh!
Yeah, either way, this is just one of those things like the raft minigame or the mining cart minigame. Where if you fall off and die, well, you'll just start over at the beginning with a game over. Thankfully, I don't think there's any point to getting a game over.
Hurry up, Musashi! This way!
Or there's no negative consequences here for falling off and dying. Thankfully, the game doesn't track game overs or anything like that. I don't think there's anything special you can get if you get through the game with, like, no game overs or anything like that. So don't worry about it. Just run like hell, hold left, and jump whenever there's a platform to jump up to. And that's all of Dark Lumina Fight 1. So yeah, that's really it. This is like an Indiana Jones sequence, and I jumped too late there.
This wasn't supposed to happen.
Well, I guess we get to see a couple game over quotes. Real easy place to show them off, I suppose. It's like the third to last fight in the game, but... Alright, enough joking around. Let's try and get this right this time.
Hurry up, Musashi! This way!
And yes, she'll say that every single time. Alright, let's not hit our jump button a half second too late and get through all these jumps. Oh, by the way, with those inclines, you can actually jump up the inclines and it'll actually be faster than if you were to run up them. So you want to just stay ahead here and, you know, make the most of your distance from each jump. So jump at the very top of the very height of your jump to move faster, I suppose. Oh, almost fell there.
You are late, Musashi! As always.
Like, sorry! Got kidnapped again!
Gojiro! You're still alive? Let go of the princess!
You actually think that you were able to get rid of me? Ha! Now how about this? If you agree to a duel, she can go free!
All right. You never give up, do you?
No time to chit-chat. Musashi, get ready to perish.
Princess, watch out!
What?
Princess!
Thank you.
Musashi, get ready to perish. Duel.
Shoot, it absorbed Gojiro. Oh well, gotta find the princess.
Oh well, indeed. Whoa, spaz out. So this part is basically Dark Lumina 1.5. This isn't quite the Dark Lumina Fight 2, but it is his second form. You just have to climb up this tower. And as you go up here, I recommend getting over each platform and pressing up as soon as you're above the platform so you don't overshoot. Kind of like that, only I just walked off there. I missed hitting X.
Shoot, if only I...
Still not a real game over at this point. You just got to make it up there. But yeah, speaking of, you know, getting up there, that's where we're going. At the top of the tower is Princess Filet. And speaking of which, at the rate of kidnapping she's been getting, or... No, you weren't. You were at the very bottom. Alright, but at the rate of... just... how many times she's gotten kidnapped in like, the past... you know, the past 5 minutes of the game, you know, she could give Princess Peach a run for her money. So, anyways, let's get this right. That's probably one of the harsh jumps, is getting on that platform, because you have to be at the very height of your double jump to make it on top. You have to be fast to get up there. All right, so freaking I.
All right,
we saw that one already. So you have to be very spot on with your timing, as you might have guessed. All right, so let's get up there. And yeah, you kind of want to be at the middle of each and every platform, just so you can get your jump off. And you gotta be very quick with the X button mashing, pretty much, or double jumping. Because you wanna get. Did it again! What is it with that? Has that been like the same platform every single time? So, how many deaths has that been? What, six, I think? I am starting to lose count. But if this is. This gets to be too much of a pattern here. I might cut out until I get a proper run up here. Sorry for the poor showing, it's just these platforms are very narrow and you've... ah. Alright, this time it's because he slid. That's not the end of me. Alright, so I'm going to use the D-pad this time and see if this works better. I don't know, maybe it's just the DualShock that's been making me slide off each ledge. Once again, same complaint I had back in the Underground Ruins when it was the last real platforming segment of the game, and I had a lot of trouble with the platforming. Oh, by the why does he keep missing that one? I know I'm pressing X right there. I don't know if that's just a glitchy platform, but I swear it's that same one every single time. But yeah, as I was saying before, same complaint I had with the dual analog stick controls is that not the best for platforming here. And he hit me.
That's not the end of
me. Alright, at least we got to hear that one. You see, this is why people hate QuickTime events. It's really just the idea of you gotta do it right or do it over, and that's really freaking annoying. And, like, even the game overs I've gotten, every single game over I've gotten in the game up to this point has not been a normal game over. It's been from cheap crap like this, like falling in a pit, or I think the raft minigame. I've never lost all my hit points normally throughout the course of this entire Let's Play. Nice, not that I remember. I mean, I've been recording this Let's Play for months now, so I could have forgotten one. But yeah, I don't think I've lost a single, you know, I don't think I've ever gotten a game over as a result of just standard combat and losing hit points, you know. It's always been events like this, which quite frankly is why quick time events are considered to be annoying. While this isn't quite a proper quick time event, it is the same vein of a quick time event. But either way, cutscenes!
Princess! Oh, I thought you were...
Musashi.
Looks like their personalities bonded, and now I guess all they want is me. No worries. I'll smash it to bits in return. Until then, stay here. And don't let anyone kidnap you again, okay?
I'll be all right. Just don't lose, okay?
Now, why couldn't we have a convenient platform like that earlier? I may actually do a bit of an outtake, because I died like half a dozen, probably a dozen more times between... I probably cut out about a dozen deaths. Either way, we're in the final proper boss fight, finally. Took so many times to get there. And obvious weak point is obvious!
What a dumb-looking wizard! I did all that to free this beast? You're gonna get it now, pal!
You're gonna get it now, pal! All right, this is where the Ruperoni SP comes in real handy. If you can get the timing right with the Ruperoni SP, you can combo that little Gemma's head. And crap. All right, that did not. That was not supposed to happen. Again, this is pretty much gonna be falling all off the tower. And I am so freaking rusty. Holy crap. So either way, I'm going to try and get this. All right, there we go. So yeah, what you want to do is hit the rope and running SP, and that rebound will cause Musashi to be in a good jumping range of the gem. That'll allow you to get another hit over and over and over again. And hopefully allow you to get a hit in on his gem. And that's what you want to avoid. Again. This attack is more annoying than anything. It obviously is meant to just throw you at the tower and start over. But, camera, please. Alright, so yeah. Double jump over that. Alright. And you kind of want to be towards his front, otherwise, because as you can see, you don't have a whole lot of time to hit his gem. And I had that. I had that hit so bad. I am sucking today. I am rusty. Now, you can't actually survive without getting hit by that. And... Alright, I'm going to start moving to the right instead, because this is getting annoying. Alright. Now, personally, I think this fight is actually a little bit easier, or a little bit harder, actually, than part 3. Because that's the only thing you need to avoid is his claw attack, where he just slams you down, throws you off the edge. And really, that's the hard part about it, this fight here. And there you go. So when he does his fire attack like that, it's easy just to stay by the side, and the fireballs will go away. Alright, doing it right now. Playing well, except for the tail swipe. There we go. And it is slightly hard to hit that gem sometimes, especially if he moves. But you can kind of get the combo going. And he'll always stagger when you get a good hit in like that. So So, double jump. Alright, and I think we're about a couple more hits away. It's really just a simple rinse and repeat fight, though. You gotta keep the combo going and get the hits in, and that's really all it is. And the Rumpuroni SP should give you enough distance to hit him with, if you get close enough, that is. He's got one hit. Jeez. That is annoying! Holy crap. There we go. Fireball, easy hit for me. It said easy hit.
Thank you.
And that ends. Brave as a Musashi. Battle is over. The Wizard of Darkness was once again sealed in the Lumina by Brave Fencer Musashi. The truth about Lumina must be known so that the wizard can never be set free again. By telling the new story, the legendary Brave Fencer Musashi.
Child, you're correct. It is all my fault. I'm awfully sorry. But you didn't have to destroy the castle, dear.
From now on, we will tell you before we take a vacation.
As long as you're sorry, huh? No, that's not what I mean.
Don't get so upset, my child.
By the way, who is that little person over there?
Oh, him? He saved my life.
Saved your life?
You don't mean that something happened while we were away?
Nothing happened? Right, Ripson?
Other than the princess's party, it doth be very peaceful every day.
See?
Princess, I'm gonna go return this. Back in a flash.
All right, Musashi. Be careful.
That's Lumina, the Sword of Luminescence.
Oh, gracious me. And the name Musashi. You cannot be.
I'm the legendary Brave Fencer Musashi. How's it going, old man?
Foul mouth to the very end. And, well, that concludes this Let's Play of Brave Fencer Musashi. Enjoy the art for now. I'm going to talk for a little bit before I let you listen to this awesome song. We'll be doing the sequel to this game, even though a lot of fans don't consider it to be much of a sequel. It is an official sequel on the PlayStation 2. It won't be for a while. It'll be a while before I get to that. I definitely want to finish Grandia and Suikoden 1 and 2 before I even consider doing regular Let's Plays on the PlayStation 2. Plus, I have other games that I plan to do in conjunction like I've been doing with, you know, three ongoing Let's Plays at a time like this that I've been doing right now. For now, though, I'm going to be going on with Suikoden and Grandia, and I'm not going to have a third Let's Play that I'm going to be doing simultaneously. I kind of want to finish up Suikoden as fast as I possibly can. But then again, there's content to get through and all that. But we'll be doing Samurai Legend Musashi. I think it's Samurai Legend Musashi. Sometime in the future. Might be a good year or two before I get there. So, look forward to that. Aside from that, we still have more to do in this Let's Play. So this isn't exactly the final episode, but stay tuned for a bonus episode where we'll be showcasing off the toys plus the final benefit to collecting all the toys. And, well, at this point, we're just going to see the rest of the credits and enjoy the music and the art. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Alright, anyways, this is why people hate QuickTime events, is because just one game over after another, and it's like there's no real punishment for failing, see? I just start right back where I was. See, this is why people hate QuickTime events, is like there's real no punishment other than you get to see the game over screen over and over again. And all it's doing is just hold me back from the actual good part of the game, which is the final boss fights. But yeah, as I was saying before, same complaint with the underground ruins. Come on! And we're doing it! Yeah, you don't want to slide. I'm trying not to slide, and I'm not using the analog stick for that very reason. Ah. You see, this is why people hate QuickTime events. It's like, there's no real punishment right now, other than you get to... Just, you gotta repeat the same... And to make matters worse, whenever he hits the tower and... And to make matters worse, whenever he hits the tower like that, all the platforms up to that point fall down. So it's not like you can just fall down to the next level below and hit a platform that you was down below. See, like that one. You gotta do it perfectly, otherwise you gotta start at the very beginning. Eh. What's even worse is all the platforms you're on, they fall down as you go. Because he'll hit the side of the tower, and that shockwave from him landing and hitting the tower like that, well, that causes all the platforms up until that point to fall down below. And, well, you can't just... It's all been just cheap crap like this. And what's worse is, as you're going up the tower and he hits the tower and tries to claw at you, all the platforms...